I do want to make one more point about meiosis in mammals. There is spermatogenesis and oogenesis, and these are the two different kinds of meiosis, right? Spermatogenesis making sperm, oogenesis making eggs. And it turns out that everything I've described to you about meiosis is spermatogenesis. So men begin doing this process in early puberty, and for their entire lives, every day, they will continue to go through meiosis and build sperm. Let me zoom in here. For women, things are going to be a little bit different. What's going to happen is we are going to go through the first set of cell divisions before we're even born. So while you're inside your mom, inside your ovaries, you're going to go through prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, and telophase 1. And at the end of telophase 1, you have these two cells. One is immediately going to dissolve, and the DNA is going to be reabsorbed, but the main body of the cell is going to mesh with the other egg, and this helps make a larger gamete, a larger kind of cell. And then what's sitting in all of our ovaries right now are these cells, these eggs, that are halfway through meiosis. And then what happens when a sperm comes to fertilize the egg and it immediately touches and is about to burrow in and drop off its DNA, it launches this cell through the rest of mitosis. So it launches it through prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase 2. It forms two cells, and one of those immediately, again, disintegrates, the DNA goes away, and this is what we're left with, and that is the final egg that gets fertilized. So for women, we don't actually form all four of these gametes. We just form one of these, and then this one may or may not go through the final steps of cell division, as many of our eggs will be shed and never fertilized. So, for example, I have two children, so I know for sure that this whole process happened twice. But beyond that, I may or may not know if there were additional fertilization events and completion of meiosis. You may hear that sometimes there are increased birth defects with moms that are older. They consider you advanced maternal age if you are 35 or above. And you can certainly have healthy children if you are age 35 or above. But one of the things that happens is this process doesn't happen quite as well. And you can get disorders like Down syndrome. And Down syndrome is when you have an extra chromosome. And that's where this final set of divisions didn't happen properly. And so you end up with an egg that has an extra chromosome in it. And so it's not a guarantee, but there is a slight increased risk of these things the older your eggs are. As men get older, there is some increase in chromosomal abnormalities as they go through this whole process of spermatogenesis regularly.